In the UN's Year of Indigenous Languages, a Minnesota community is fighting to keep ancient Native Indian American culture from fading away. It's part of a global push to stop the loss of endangered Indigenous languages.
Peter Segekwe Peterson-Briggs won't let go of the Ojibwe culture without a fight. She's teaching students about the Ojibwe and Dakota people to pass on a legacy that's endured thousands of years and is in danger of disappearing. Beyond the spoken word, they're exploring sound, sight, and taste.
The Ojibwe language is very important to me, specifically, because I didn't grow up speaking it.
600 languages have disappeared in the past century. That's one every 2 months. A further 40% of the world's remaining 6,700 languages could still be lost. And almost all of those under threat are indigenous.
English is a very pervasive language, especially now. There's with a lot of the politics of the day, non-English speakers are kind of have a target, or they stand out more.
That is my plan.
But languages aren't just falling to the side in favor of mainstream speech. Entire cultures die out with them.
Very sadly, I've been present at funerals where we've laid into the earth the last person who carried all that knowledge, not just for one language sometimes, but for several.
In Australia, the issue and its impact on First Nations people is profound. In 1900, there were at least 250 Indigenous languages spoken across the continent. Today, just 13 are still being passed on to the next generation.
Language is closely tied to country, where you are, and to spiritual aspects of country. So it's just like pulling out your guts in a way.
It's the reason this Minnesota teacher counts her own daughter among her students at Bdote Hall.
It's tough growing up not knowing who you are, and that's why the language and culture here at this school is so important. I want my kids here at this school, especially my own child, to grow up knowing who they are.
As teachers and parents hope, long after they're gone, these tribes and their stories endure.
I have an Ojibwe heart and I have an English heart.
Camille Bianchi, SBS World News.